Hi guys, Gerard O'Neill here at Woolcastle Dagreen. So today I started a job for a customer. It's a three-story hall storage land, and there's a lot of work involved in this job here now. A lot of woodwork. There's a data reel. The bottom half of the data reel has paper. The customer wants that stripped and wants the walls painted. So it's going to be a bit of preparation there to get the walls right. And again, I've come across a problem with these walls, which I'm sure a lot of people have come across, and a lot of people don't know why this happens, but I'm going to explain why you get this problem. And the main problem is, from the very start, it's the original painter who paints these houses when they're brand new, the bare plaster. So basically the paint is bubbling on the plaster, and I'm sure you've come across that. You know, I come across it a lot. You know, whenever you're painting walls, the paint starts bubbling away. And the reason for that is, whenever the house was brand new, and the plaster, in my opinion, has still moisture in it. Which is why, you know, for example, I'll use Crown Trade as an example. If I'm doing a new build house, the only paint they'll stand over is Crown Cover Mat, because it's a breathable paint. Unless the plaster is dried at least 6 months, you know, because you think the plaster's dry, but there's a lot of moisture in it. So what happens is, these painters go in, you know, they're on a price, and basically all they do is they just fire on this paint. If it's a fennel mat and there's fennel in the paint, the fennel traps the moisture. That's basically what happens. And it looks fine at the time. But say a few years down the line, say a customer of mine wants me to go in and do a paint job. I start painting the wall. All of a sudden, all this paint's starting to bubble. So basically, it's moisture trying to get out of the trapped plaster. Pulls the paint away from the wall. And that's where you're getting this, you know. So it can be sorted, you know what I mean? But there's extra work in it for me, and I'll show you exactly. So I've started stripping these walls here, and I'm going to show you what I've done. So as you can see at the bottom here, you know, you can see where all the paint's come away there, okay? And so the whole idea is basically what you have to do is you have to take every loose bit of paint away. Make sure the paint, this paint here, for example, you have to make sure it's really tight, because whenever I sand that and paint it, you know, if there's any loose stuff, it'll bubble and I'll have to take it away again. So you have to make sure it's all away. Now, I'll give you an example here, over here in this corner. You know, there's a bit of trap condensation in there, as you can see, which I need to treat. Just here, you can see there, well, it's all coming away there. Like that. And that's just an example, you know, which I have to go around, you know. So you can see there, you know, it's just come away from the plaster, you know, never give a chance to dry out. And as I say, you can get breathable paint. And my advice for anybody who has a brand new house, you know, for me, I use Crown Cover Mat, which is a breathable paint. And if you put it over new plaster, if it's say 2 months old and there's moisture in the plaster, the moisture is able to come through the breathable paint. That's what causes this problem. On this wall here, I've stripped here, as you can see, all the paint's nearly come off the wall, as you can see there. Then if I come up here to this area, as you can see here, there's the paint has tightened up again, you know. And then there you go, just doing a bit of stripping here, just there, just to, as you can see, there was a heavy fennel on. I peeled the top section off, give that back in the soaking, as you can see, it's all ready to come off, you know. But you know, so whenever these walls dry, basically what I need to do is make sure all the bubbles and loose paint, what you do is take all the loose stuff away, give the walls a good sand down, and flush fill the edge here of the paint, the tight paint that's staying, fill the edge of it there. sand it down, and then paint your walls, you know. So I'll just go on up here. So as you can see, this is a big job. All these doors here, they're all getting, there's one, two, three, there's four doors on this first floor. You have three sections of spindles. They're going up to the top floor. You have that section there. You have this section here. Then this customer has all these nice fancy cornices all the way around, and you know, as you can see, and ceiling roses, and they're all ceilings and cornices are all going brilliant white. And I'll just let you have a look up here. There's the third floor, and again, look at, there's all them spindles. They all get sanded down, two coats of white satin. There's a door up there as well. And there's the paper here shown on the first floor. So that's what I have to take off. And again, I'm running into this trouble where all the paint's bubbling. So if anybody ever comes across that, and I'm sure you have, even painters, you know, that's the reason. You know, when the house was new, it was just painted over with a final paint or a silk or whatever, and it's trapped the moisture. The plaster hadn't been fully dried, you know, which is very important. You know, you need to know what you're doing whenever you're at this trade. You know, there's guys that really don't have a clue, and that's the truth, you know. And they really do make our trade, give our trade a bad name. You know, even when you're quoting for jobs, they're coming in with prices that's ridiculous. You know, they're not doing half the preparation. They're not using quality paint. They're not keeping the place neat and tidy. You know, and people, genuine customers, think they're getting a bargain, and realistically they're not. The amount of jobs that I've done after so-called painters, honestly, I loads of work after them. It costs a customer more money. I've had to strip off wallpaper that hasn't been done right. And if they buy more wallpaper, I have to do more preparation, whatever. So this job here, basically, I have a three-story hall storage alarm to do. I have two bedrooms to do, and I have a kitchen downstairs to do as well. There's a feature wall in each room with a Laura Icy wallpaper going on, which I'm going to do a wee video on hanging Laura Icy wallpaper, cross-lining it, and then a finished wallpaper, Laura Icy. So, you know, but I just wanted to bring up this, their attention, this, you know, this paint bubbles on jobs, do you know what I mean? And so, as I say, if you do come across it, the solution is, you know, whenever you see the paint bubbling, scrape it all, take all the loose stuff away, make sure every bit of it, it has to be all taken away, you know. Not all of it will come away, as I say. If you look down at that section that I showed you there, a lot of it was tight, but, you know, and then you have to flush fill all the edges of the paint that's still on the wall so you don't notice it, you know. So you scrape it all away, and then give all the wall a good sand down, and seal it, and then put your two coats of whatever paint you want to put on. You know, I'm using Crown Clean Extremes and acrylic paint, very good paint, you know, and I do use that a lot, and I'm very happy with it. I'm using Crown Cover Mat on the ceilings, brilliant white, the breathable paint that I was telling you about, and I'm using Crown white oil-based satin on all the woodwork, the doors, frames, spindles and skirting boards. But anyway, if anybody has any questions on that, if they've come across that problem and you know, they're not sure what to do, by all means, sure, leave me a message and I'll get back to you when I can. Thanks, now, bye.